students, welcome back. Today we will start a new topic in maths for class 4, that is patterns. Patterns can be seen everywhere. You find patterns on clothes, on bed sheets, on floor tiles, on ceilings, in jewelry and also in rangoli designs. In this chapter we will learn more about patterns.
Patterns are created when objects, shapes or numbers are arranged in a particular order and are repeated over and over again. The way in which the pattern is repeated is called the sequence of the pattern. Patterns can be of three types: repeating pattern, growing pattern and reducing patterns. A repeating pattern is a pattern in which the same sequence is repeated over and over again. A growing pattern is a pattern that increases or grows in number. A reducing pattern is a pattern that decreases or reduces in number. In all the three types of patterns, a repetition rule is used to continue the pattern. Once we find out the rule of repetition, we can continue any given pattern. So, our first step is to find out the rule applied to the given pattern. Now, let us see the different types of patterns. First, we will see repeating patterns using shapes and numbers.
This is an example of repeating pattern. Children, look at the arrangement of the cards. I have some cards here: orange, yellow, blue, orange, yellow, and the next one in the sequence will be blue. So see, this is a repeating pattern: orange, yellow, blue, orange, yellow, blue, and it will continue further like this. Look at this example of repeating pattern using numbers. In this pattern we have number 1 2 1 2, so the next number here will be 1 followed by 2. Again we will have 1 and followed by 2. So see, we have a repeated pattern here: 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And this is an example of repeating pattern using numbers.
Growing patterns using shapes and numbers.
This is an example of a growing pattern. See, and first find out what is the rule in this pattern. In the first case there is one flower. In the second case there are two flowers here. Next, we have arranged 1, 2, 3 flowers. So, this pattern is growing, that is number of flowers is growing in each step. So, what will be the next order here? We will have 1, 2, 3 and 4. Flowers. See here, 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3 and 3 plus 1, 4. So this is an example of a growing pattern. Let us see some examples of growing patterns using numbers. Look at the first pattern here. In this series, we will first find the rule which is applied or followed. Now, the first number is 10. Now next number is 20. So if I add 10 to this first number, I will get 20, right? 20 plus 10 again will give me 30, right? 30 plus 10 will give me 40, right? Now, to get the next number in this series or in this pattern, we will have to add 10 to 40. 40 plus 10 will be how much? 50. So the next number here again will be 50 plus 1, 10, sorry, that is 60. And the next number will be 60 plus 10, that is 70, right? So this is a growing pattern using numbers, and each time we have added 10. Look at the next example. You have to find the number in the pattern here. So first let us find the rule. I have 1, 2, 3, 5, 8 and 13. So what we have to do is 1 plus 2, if I add these two numbers together, I will get the third number, right? See, 1 plus 2 is how much? 3, that is the third number. 3 plus 2, if I add these two numbers, I will get the next number. See, 3 plus 2 is how much? 5. So that is my next number. Now, 5 plus 3 is 8. So I get my next number here. 5 plus 3 will give me 8. Now, 5 plus 8 will give me how much? 13, which is coming next. So 5 plus 8 is 13, which is my next number. Now, in order to find the number in this gap here, what will we do? We will add 13 and 8. We will add 8 plus 13, and that will give us how much? 21. So the next number here which will fit in this pattern will be 21. And what have we done here? We have added the first two numbers and got the next number. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 5, 13. And 13 plus 8 is 21. The next example is also a growing pattern using numbers. We will first try to find out the rule followed in this pattern. Look here, the first number is 4. 4 multiplied by 10 will be how much? 40. 40 multiplied by 10 again will give me 400, right? 400 multiplied by 10 will give me 4000. To find the next number here, what will we do? 4000 multiplied by 10. So what is it? 40,000. So the next number in this pattern or series is 40,000. So this again is an example of a growing pattern using numbers.
Reducing patterns using shapes and numbers.
This is an example of a reducing pattern. First, we will try and find out the rule followed in this pattern. In the first case, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 flowers. Then they become 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, they have reduced to 1, 2, 3. So in each case, they are reducing by 1. So what will be the next number of flowers here, next in the sequence? The next will be 1, 2 flowers, right? So 3 minus 1 is 2. Now 2 minus 1 will be 1. So this will be a complete pattern. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. In each case, the flower is reducing by 1. And so it is called a reducing pattern. Let's see some examples of reducing patterns using numbers. Now, look at the first example. Let us first try and find out the rule followed in this pattern. Now, if you see, 16 minus 2 will give us 14, right? 14 minus 2 will give us 12. 12 minus 2 will give us 10, right? So what do we see here? We see a rule that every time we have to minus 2 from the number to get the next number. So now 10 minus 2 should give us the next number here in this gap. So 10 minus 2 is how much? 8, right? Now the next number will be what? 8 minus 2. What is 8 minus 2? 6. So, this is an example of reducing pattern. See, the numbers are reducing here by 2 each time. 16, 14, 12, 10, 8 and 6. From 16, it has gone down to 6. Look at the next example. Here, the rule is 30 minus 3 if we do, we will get 27, right? 27 minus 3 if we do, we get 24. 24 minus 3 again is 21. And 21 minus 3 will give us 18, right? Now, to get the next number here after 18, what we will do? We will have to subtract 3 from 18. So, 18 minus 3, then that is how much? Equals to 15. So, this again is an example of a reducing pattern. From our number 30, we have come down each time minusing 3.
Patterns are seen everywhere. Now, let us see an example of patterns found in nature.
Patterns are also found in nature. The arrangement of the leaves on the stem is an example of patterns found in nature. Look at the first case here. Here, both the leaves are attached to the stem at the same point. This point is called a node. See here, both the leaves are opposite to each other and they are attached at the same point. So, this arrangement is called the opposite arrangement of leaves. Look at the second case here. Here, you can see that the leaves are arranged on the stem in a different pattern. They are alternately arranged. They do not attach at the same point, but they have been alternately arranged on the stem. So this is another pattern of arrangement of leaves on the stem, and it is called an alternate arrangement of leaves.
Here are some examples of patterns found in jewelry.
Patterns are also found in jewelry. Look at the beautiful patterns in this jewelry. See here. Each and every item has a separate pattern. And see how beautiful they look.
Now, let us apply the concept and solve the given examples.
The next pattern here is a reducing pattern. So now, we will check out the rule which is used in this pattern. The rule here is 67 minus 5 is 62. 62 minus 5 will give me how much? 57. 57 minus 5 will give me how much? 52. 52 minus 5 will give me the next number. And that is how much, children? 47, right? Now, to get the next number here, what will we do? Again, 47 minus 5. And how much it will be? 42. So, we have completed this reducing pattern. Look at the next pattern. You have M, inverted M. M, and what will come next? What will come next here? Again, we will have inverted M. And again, we will have M. So, this is a repeating pattern with alphabets. The next one again is a reducing pattern. We'll try to find out the rule, children. 99 minus 10 will be how much? 89. 89 minus 10 will be how much? 79. 79 minus 10 will be how much? 69. So, if you want the next number in this pattern or series, what will you do? 69 minus 10. And that will give me how much? 59. The next pattern here. 72 is reducing to 69. So 72 minus 3 will give me 69. 69 minus 3 will give me 66. 66 minus 3 will give me again 63. So if I want the next two numbers, what will I do? 63 minus 3, and that is how much? 60, right?
Children, I hope you have all enjoyed watching this video. See you again in the next session. Till then, take good care of yourselves. Thank you.